Mr. Chairman, and I would like to thank Professor Chairman Ranieri and the organizers of the meeting for this wonderful meeting. And my talk would be on a very recognized to be a rare disease or an orphan disease of immunotherapy, which is small cell lung cancer. So much changes that you find in small cell line therapy is well known in small cell lung cancer, should be offered to the patient. It's a platinum containing regimen. Mostly it is erythrocyte and cisplatin or carboplatin, and you may give to performance to be as much recommended. The size of treatment would be erythrocyte in excess of disease, erythrocyte and cisplatin for carboplatin. There were a lot of data about the investigations that were done before, like alternative chemotherapy, like non-cisplatin regimen, like increasing the dose intensity, maintenance chemotherapy, increasing the number of chemotherapy agents, all this to avoid the relapse that happened in most of the cases of small cell lung cancer after having like 80% or 70% remission with the first line. All these trials or these options were failure. There were some data about using irinotecan and not to use the erythrocyte. There were data that were posted first in Japan, but these data were not justified in the Southwest Oncology Group data and the data of HANA Group and the Southwest Oncology Group. So still up till now, the first line therapy is erythrocyte, cisplatin, or carboplatin. For second line treatment, we see the response to the first line chemotherapy. We see the time to progression from the first line. We see the performance status. We see if there is a presence or absence of any comorbidity for the patient and the adequacy of the first line chemotherapy. All these factors will depend on to see if we are going to give the second line chemotherapy or not and what to give for the patient. Patient having sensitive disease. And we say sensitive disease when we have like more than 90 days after remission of the patient. So when the patient relapses, it's considered to be sensitive disease. And in this case, he may receive the first line that he has received before, which is the platinum-containing regimen. But for if the patient is, again, having this sensitive disease but cannot tolerate the treatment before or have any contraindication, you may give one agent, which is fluoxetine or irinotecan. The overall survival is present between fluoxetine versus best supportive care, proving that this is a second line that is approved up to now. We have also for the refractory cases, usually these cases have to go to clinical trials. We cannot have them much, but there are some drugs like topotecan and irinotecan, paclitaxel, docetaxel, gemcitabine, anything can be given for these patients, but it will not be a big addition. There was also the ambrubicin, and we have several trials on ambrubicin in small cell lung cancer, comparing ambrubicin to topotecan, and they were very similar to each other with less toxicity. Coming to the issue of PCI after Slotman in the year 2007, small cell lung cancer extensive disease is now having as a routine PCI, which is a prophylactic cranial irradiation after admission like 4 cycles or so. And for the patients that are having considered to be old age, it's not wise to give them this PCI because of the toxicity and the neurocognitive impairment that is considered to most patients. And this is the result of PCI in extensive and in limited disease small cell lung cancer, proving that there were positive in extensive and in limited disease, and it is usually recommended to give this PCI after remission of the patient. So in short, extensive disease, small cell lung cancer, that accounts for less than 15% of all lung cancers. It has a poor outcome. The median overall survival in general is 8 to 12 months, and the 5-year survival is 1 to 3%. And the total size of diseases can lead to 5 years. The first line treatment is considered to be standard for 6 cycles of radiation treatment is a remission. And for second line treatment, single agent corticosteroid or the therapy that was received before, if this is sensitive disease. Now, you saw in non-small cell lung cancer how much they were interested in non-small cell lung cancer for immunotherapy and how much trials have been done to see the effect with immunotherapy, whether as second line and now as first line. Coming to this small cell lung cancer, really the trials are very little in amount or scarce, and you see here the first trial, which is CheckMate 032, and this was comparison nivolumab with or without ipilimumab for the treatment of recurrent small cell lung cancer. As you heard before, nivolumab is an anti-PD-1 drug which is used in immunotherapy, and this is the addition of ipilimumab, which is an anti-CTLA-4. So the both drugs together will be used. So nivolumab, as we said, is an immune checkpoint inhibitor antibody. It has demonstrated survival benefit and manageable safety profile in advanced non-small cell lung cancer and other tumors like melanoma. And nivolumab plus ipilimumab has demonstrated promising activity across other tumor types. So the trend is to use to more blockage of checkpoint, like using both the CTLA-4 inhibitor and the PD-1 ipilimumab and its action, as you saw before, and the nivolumab and its action as a PD-1 inhibitor, as you see before, now escaping the tumor from the effect of the immune system. And now, after using these drugs, we are expecting that the immune system will be cleared from the effect of the PD-1 inhibitor. If you go to this trial, which is the CheckMate 032, there were 128 cases of small cell lung cancer and progressing after receiving more or one prior line of therapy, which is usually platinum-based chemotherapy. And here, they took all the patients. They did not select according to the PD-1 expression, as you saw in the non-small cell lung cancer trials. So, and they divided the cases as they didn't know properly the dose that should be used. So nivolumab 3 milligrams per kilo every 2 weeks, or nivolumab 1 milligram per kilo plus ipilimumab 1 milligram, and all nivolumab 1 milligram per kilo and ipilimumab 3 milligrams per kilo, or nivolumab 3 and ipilimumab 1. And the primary, and to follow by the end with maintenance with nivolumab every 2 weeks. And the primary objective was the response rate using the RECIST 1.1, and the secondary objective, as usual, was the safety, and they explored the analysis of potential free survival, overall survival, and of course the biomarker analysis was done. In this trial, here are the patient characteristics, and you see clearly that they are well balanced, the two groups, whether receiving the nivo again alone or with the ipilimumab, and everything was very well balanced between the two groups, whether the age, the male, the race, the number of prior treatment, and sensitivity to first line of platinum treatment, whether the cases were sensitive to platinum or resistance of the refractory. And here you see the tumor response for the cases small cell lung cancer, for the cases receiving the nivo and the cases receiving the nivo plus the ipilimumab. So for the ipilimumab, we have PD-L1 expression level less than 1%, 68%, and more than 1% in 32%. And the same ones were very similar, 67% and 33% in the combination of nivolumab plus the overall survival is present on this slide, and you see clearly that in the neuro map it was 4.4 months, the median overall survival, while in the combination it was double, it was 8.2 months. And this happened again previously in the non-small cell lung cancer. 2 minutes. The treatment adverse events, you saw it previously, but look here, if you compare the nivolumab to the nivolumab plus ipilimumab combination, you see clearly that the grade 3 and 4 were much more in the combination, toxicity was more in the combination than the single agent. For the single agent, there were no practically grade 3 to 4, it is very safe to give the nivolumab or any anti-PD-L1 drug. The second trial that was presented was pembrolizumab in patients with extensive stage small cell lung cancer. And again, here, which is not at the keynote, 028, this is also was it's not the first line treatment, it's for the cases that received treatment previously and failure of previous therapy, and they give the pembrolizumab. And either we have complete or partial response, and return to treat for a period of 2 years, 24 months, and then we follow the patient. So the PD-L1 screening for such a trial for the small cell lung cancer patient, you see that the patient screened were 157, but the samples evaluated was only 147, and the PD-L1 positive tumors were only 42 cases. Again, the patient treated as of March 13, 2015, were only 20. So you see how much, if we depend on this PD-L1 evaluation, we may not treat anyone with immunotherapy. It would be very difficult. So the adverse events of the interest based on immune etiology, as you heard previously from Professor Yasser Abdel-Eder, the most important here was the autoimmune thyroiditis and the colitis, which was aggressive for this patient. But no cases had this tumor. If you look at the anti-tumor activity, again, we have here responding patients, 35% ahead. Partial response and still disease 5%. And you see here the change from baseline on tumor size according to the RECIST evaluation. But what is more important is the duration of response. Even when you stop treatment, as you saw before, we have a continued effect of the drug even when we stop the treatment. It's very likely to the non-small cell lung cancer, but I think definitely trials in non-small cell lung cancer were much more in number and in cases. So this is another study that was present for small cell lung cancer. I think this is the last one you can have in the literature. This is one was by Martin Reck trial, and here they used small cell lung cancer cases and divided them into cases that received concurrent chemotherapy with immunotherapy, or what we guess phased means you take 2 cycles first of chemotherapy and then you receive the immunotherapy, which is the ipilimumab with the chemotherapy, and versus the control. And we see from this slide that only the phased type, which is receiving first the chemotherapy, and then after receiving these 2 cycles of chemotherapy, you have the right to be randomized between either to be a control case that received only chemotherapy or to receive this ipilimumab with chemotherapy, which is carboplatin in this study. The only one that was statistically significant was related to progression-free survival and overall survival was the phased type, not the concurrent and not the control. So, sorry for the delay. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Professor Gata. Any questions? Thank you very much. Now we're going to move to Professor